Hello everyone, welcome back. Gene here, back on the 1964 Impala wagon. Today I'm going to be working on the frame horns. I'm going to walk over here and pick up the camera and show you what I'm going to be doing. So what I'm going to be doing is I'm going to be straightening the driver's side, which would be the left frame horn, which is just a little bit out of whack from what looks like a fender bender. And what happens is this frame horn is bent towards the inside. And I'm going to show you some measurements here in a second. But what I want to do is I want to straighten it. I'm going to need to make a cut. And the cut is going to be approximately in this area. And I'll draw some lines to show that to you. And then I'm going to take and bend the frame horn out this way. So that should get it to line back up, and then I can re-weld this cut. I'm not going to cut it all the way off. I'm just going to cut on the bottom, slice it up through here, and to the top, leaving this side totally intact. Then what I'll do is, if I can, I'm just going to try and bend it out like this. If it doesn't bend, then what I'll have to do is go back over onto this side and heat this area right in here and see if I can get it to bend that way. So that's going to be the effort for today, and I'll get into some more details here in a moment. The way I've figured that I'll be able to straighten this out is to take a measurement crossways across the two frame horns, and from this side over here where this hole is to where this hole is at it crossways, I'm showing, let's see here, maybe split it, 34 and a 32nd. And then if I come across this side, so first I'll write this down. Then on this side, I'm going to do the same thing. I'm going to take this measurement in that same spot, hopefully. And what I'm showing on this side is 33 and 5/8, right on the nuts, 33 and 5/8. Write that down on here. So what we'll do, what did they say to do? They say to measure twice and cut once. Let's do it. And I'm showing 34 and a 32nd. So that looks good. Let's do this one. I like that spot. This is showing 33 and 5/8. 33 and 5/8. So we're good. Thank you. Okay, so those are my measurements. So what, you say? What are you gonna do about it? Well, I'll tell you here. I'm gonna slide my little stool over here and explain it. So what I have to do with this one is take and move it out. This has got to come out to where this measurement from here to here will illustrate. We've got, this one's at 33 5/8, this one's at 34 and a 32nd. So what we have to do is make this one come out till it meets 34 and a 32nd. So what do I gotta go? I gotta go 1, 2, 3, a little over 3/8 out. 1, 2, 3, almost a half inch out. So let's check that. Okay, so this has got to come out almost a half inch from back here. So if I slice in here, I'll make maybe two slices and then try and bend it out and try and get that 34 and a 32nd, or right at 34 or close. If I get it within a 32nd, that'd be amazing. So that's what the challenge is going to be. I got to get rid of this little tip right here. It's driving me nuts. Okay, so nice and straight. Let's try this again. Okay, so it's nice and straight. Pretty straight. Right up to here. Let's bring it down some more. So it's pretty straight right up to here. And then if you look over here from this side, it's pretty straight right up to here. So in between these two spots is where I'm going to make a cut. You gotta watch out for this. And I gotta watch out for, see, if it's gonna go straight up and down, I'm gonna be cutting right into here. If this one is gonna be cutting right into the threaded, well, actually, this can come out, so that's not gonna be a problem. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna try and make a straight up and down cut. And if I make it straight up and down, it's gonna come straight across. But if I don't, it's gonna come up. It's kinda like this, it'll come up. But if I make it straight up and down, it's going to go level. So we want it to go straight and level. So each of my cuts got to be straight up and down. So when this moves, if it's not straight up and down, it's either going to go down, or go up. So we got to go straight up and down. So I'm going to turn the camera off and do a little playing around and do some marking. That keeps getting in the way. Okay. So, if I come there, it should work out pretty good. And you go in farther on this one. Gotta be careful here, this is bucking back a little bit on me while I'm doing this body piece, so. I'm making a mess of it. Okay, that's all the way through. Second, right? I'm going to go ahead and cut that. All right, I need 34 and a second, right? 34 and 1/32. Wow. I'm gonna clamp this thing down. Times I'm gonna do that wrong. Damn, that's nice. Okay, let's shut the camera off for a little bit and get this thing ready to weld. Okay, so I'm welding 3/32. So 3/32 is slightly smaller than an eighth, right? Which is 4/32. And I'm using 030 wire and 7525 gas. So let's go with the 19 and 354 settings on my welder. It'll be set up for 1/8. Maybe I'll go a little bit lower, slightly lower, since it's a little bit old and rusty. Okay, so let's try this again. So we need 19 and 354. So there's, and we're on the 240 scale. There's 320, there's 400, half of that, so that's 80, half of that is 40, so that'd be 360, minus a little bit, right about there, 350, let's say, and then this is supposed to be at 19, which would be right there. We're gonna take it down just slightly. So that's the settings I'm gonna use. Okay, I need some light. Oh, come on, stay on there. Really? I'm gonna struggle with this? That's pretty good. Shall we try this again?
God, I got a mess going.
That looks terrible.
Pretty goddamn close. Let's look over on this side, make sure I'm lined up right. Oh yeah. Let's do it this way. Make sure it's right there. Pretty goddamn close. And this one. Holy shit, it's right there. I'm going with it. Well, after all this time, I finally got this frame horn repaired. Not the prettiest welding job I've ever done, but yeah, I think it's doing real good. It's nice and straight, and we'll dress up those welds when I do the prep for painting it. So that's enough of that. So we move on to the next task. All right, well, that's the end of this frame horn repair. I'm glad I finally got to that. It's been bothering me for a while. Like I said earlier, I'll dress up those welds when I do the prep for painting all of this. I've got to put the wire wheel onto this and clean it up, and like I say, dress those welds, and then put some Pour 15 on it. So moving along real nice. So hey, if you guys like this video, hit like and leave me a comment and tell me how things are going or what you think, or if you have any questions. And always feel free to subscribe. All right, folks, we're going to move on to the next task.